Philadelphia's Commerce Department said today it plans to spend $1.5 million on waterfront improvement next year. The money will be used to spruce up the Delaware Riverfront, modernize some of the city-owned piers, and to buy 3 piers now owned by the Army. Montgomery County Court has set a trial date of October 20th for Mrs. Ethel Kravitz, who has been held without bail for the 4th of July killing of her husband. 48-year-old Max Kravitz was beaten and shot to death in the bedroom of their Wynwood home. A Feasterville, Bucks County man was among those killed yesterday when a New Jersey Central commuter train plunged into Newark Bay. He was identified as W.H. Gebhardt of Indian Passway, Feasterville. Nearly 100,000 Philadelphians have registered to vote in the 4-month registration period, which ended yesterday. Democrats outnumbered Republicans by better than 2-1 in new registrations. In another political note, the Philadelphia Republican Party has selected Mrs. Elizabeth Page Hanna of Olney to be their candidate for city council in the 9th District. Mrs. Hanna, born in England, will oppose Henry Carr of the 42nd Ward, who was also born in England. John D. Kelly, one of Philadelphia's most prominent business and civic leaders, was presented the NBC Public Service Award today for his outstanding contributions to the community for his efforts in behalf of the Hero Scholarship Fund. The award is presented to Mr. Kelly by Raymond Wellpark, NBC Vice President and General Manager of WRCB at WRCB-TV. The Hero Scholarship Fund provides scholarships for children of Philadelphia police, firemen, and park guards killed or permanently disabled in the line of duty. The opening of Pennsylvania's first low-vision rehabilitation center was announced today by the Working Home for the Blind. The new center, located at 36th and Lancaster, will be operated as part of the Prevention of Blindness Department under the direction of Dr. Sidney Weiss. Special lenses, magnifying glasses, and other optical aids will be provided to those persons who are considered near blind. There was strong evidence today of the pinch that colleges and universities across the country will feel this year at freshman registration at least at Temple University. An estimated 1,500 new students enrolled for classes today in Minton Memorial Hall, Gordon Birch Street. The increase in number of persons continuing on for a college education and the increase in the number of students across the country, the physical plans of the institutions have not been able to keep pace. However, Temple, for one, is in the midst of a gigantic expansion and renewal program which will help alleviate the problem there in just a few years. In another effort to meet the challenge of higher education, Temple, along with Penn and the University of Pittsburgh, has asked the state legislature for a substantial increase in their allotments for next year. And naval ROTC officials have announced that more young men may enroll in the ROTC program at Villanova, University of Pennsylvania, and up at Princeton. And here are the closing Dow Jones stock averages. Industrials up $3.17. Rails up $1.25. Utilities up 10 cents. Sales total 3,940,000 shares. Listen again tomorrow at 6:06 for Delaware Valley Report with Paul Taylor. There's mystery, intrigue, and suspense in Contraband Spain. In color with Richard Green, Michael Dellison, now at the Green Hill, 63rd and Lancaster Avenue. This is WRCP.